Hey there, I'm Eric, and AliExpress sent me out the 580C Bafang screen to review. This is another one of those stealth screens, but this one has a little bit more information than the last two I reviewed. So let's go ahead and install this on the solar Bafang. If you want to know any more information about the solar Bafang, I have lots of videos on how to build this. So I'm going to go ahead and take off the screen, and pretty much you just got to simply unplug it and the uninstall is done. For the next one, I'm going to install it onto the bars, line up these two arrows. They're really hard to see, so you can use the two notches. That works just as good, maybe even better because they're more visible, and plug it in. So just like that, the installation is done. To turn it on, it has this little hidden button on the bottom. You just go ahead and hold that down for a few seconds and it'll turn on the screen. Hello. That's cute. With the screen on, it actually has 9 pedal assists. So you can press the up buttons and quickly scan up through all those assist modes, or the down arrows to go back down through them. If you hold the top plus down, it will turn on the headlight. As you can see by the indicator there, I don't have a headlight on the bike right now. Go ahead and push that, turn the headlight back off. Another one of the features here is if you hold the negative button down for a few seconds, it's going to kick the bike into an auto walk mode. And that comes in handy when you got a big load and you're going up a hill. You need a little bit of assistance and the motor will help a little bit, but won't let the bike get away from you. And now with the power button, push it once and it'll go into a different mode here. Now it's showing a different display for it, just kind of same information, just rearranged. And then for the third one, that has all kinds of time information for the bike. Okay, at the very top, there's an M button here. This is your menu, your mode button, whatever you want to call it. So let's go ahead and hit that, and now you can see that switched that from the trip miles to the speed over to the watts. But yeah, it has like 3 settings there. Okay, to get into the menu, go ahead and turn the screen off, turn it back on, and then immediately hit the M button twice to get into the menu system. Had to do it a couple times there. You do it real rapidly and then we'll get into it. To select the first menu here, which you see that little screen kind of looks like a display, just go ahead and tap the menu button and that'll get into that. So we have language. Language is good. System, let's go ahead and go into that real quick. So that's right here, system. This will switch you from kilometers or into miles per hour. Miles per hour is what they call imperial. So to do that, you hit the mode button and then hit the up button once. The mode button is kind of like the select on it. Okay, now that we got the language set to imperial or miles per hour, let's go ahead onto this one, and this is brightness. So this obviously changes the screen's brightness on it. I'm gonna leave it all the way up there. Quite like it actually. Auto off pretty much just specifies how long it takes the screen to turn off and the bike's not being used. So we got, let's see, 5 minutes, 6 minutes. Let's see how long it goes, all the way up to 10 minutes on that. So I find 5 minutes usually pretty appropriate on those. And now we can go ahead and hit the back and we're into the full menu. Let's go over to the next one, check it out. The bike setting. So here you can put a password into the bike. If you do this, you better remember it because I don't actually know how to reset it. We're gonna go ahead and skip that setting. I protect my bike and other means. Assist level, let's go ahead and go into that. So here you can change your screen to either 5, 3, or 9 assist levels. I prefer the 9, it gives you more range of customization. Okay, and then now this one, this is definitely one you're gonna wanna set here. This is the wheel size. So on this particular bike, I have 29-inch wheels. So go ahead and hit the mode, and I'm gonna go up to 29. Just check to see how big it goes up to. Looks like 31, and then it goes into centimeters here for a while. So if it, no, it's still going. Okay, so it has definitely a wide range of tire sizes. Let's see the smallest that the screen will work for. And it looks like, let's get out of it, 12-inch, wow, okay. So this will work all the way down to a 12-inch tire. Let's go ahead and put it back up at a 29-inch, so the speedometer reads right. Battery, let's go ahead and go into that setting. So this bike uses a 48-volt battery system, so I'm gonna put it on that setting. Battery indicator, ooh, fancy. Voltage, I actually prefer to see a percentage on that. I know the percentage is based off voltage, but it's still nice to have it. It's definitely one of the reasons I like this screen, is because it has that type of information. Power indicator, not too sure of that. Power and current, not sure. I would have thought that was like the last setting. And let's go back. So we're out of that menu now. Let's go ahead and go into the next one. And the password for this one is 1919. All right, so in here we have a pretty cool setting. This is a speed limit. So if you have kids or anything, you could get into here and you could basically specify how fast they're able to go. This is a great feature. I don't actually recommend your kids going over 20 miles per hour unless you got really great health insurance. Let's go ahead and go into the speed limit setting, and we can see it's set at 61.4 miles per hour. My bike would never do that. Let's go ahead and see what its limits are here. Oh wow, 6.2 miles per hour. So that definitely has a low end setting on it. Obviously I'm gonna leave it on the 61.4 for myself. Let's go ahead and hit back on that. And that is all the advanced features on that one. So let's go to this setting here. This is basically a factory reset, and no, we don't wanna do this. So we're gonna go ahead and go back. Okay, and let's just go into this one here. This one here has information about the system. So we got product information. This is basically showing your current firmware on the controller. Let's go ahead and hit back on there. And we have battery information here, which that's pretty cool. Some of the information's not showing. It may only work with the newer Bafang batteries that have more of this data on it. I don't know, I'll have to see after riding that a bit. Go to the next page. Yeah, this definitely has some information that my battery's not able to feed back on there. Oh, that's pretty cool. So this would work with the newer Bafang, it looks like. One here is just a simple exit. That sends you right back to the main screen. And this is very cool. I got all the information I wanted on a very tiny little screen, which is nice. So I got percentage over here, which I need that for touring to kind of gauge if I need to back off the power or not. And then over here, this one is very important. Let's go ahead and hit the mode button a few times to cycle through it. And now you can see it's watts used. This will help out greatly with touring to be able to keep my watts real low and to be able to get the extreme range out of it. Nice. I am loving this little screen. I just noticed, to get on a straightaway here real quick, it'll do over 999 watts. Do full throttle. Yeah, nice. It's now displaying almost 1200 on it. Sweet. That's cool. I thought it cut off at 999, but no, I was wrong on that one. So, hey, that's a con turned into a plus right there. Let's turn it back down. I don't need to be going quite that fast. And I guess this little bar over here on the left must stand for the amount of speed or something. I'm not too sure. Nice. I really am loving this screen. This is the favorite stealth screen I've reviewed so far. I have a feeling this one's going to stay with me on all my next tours. Yeah, no joke. I am loving this screen. You can find a link in the description below for this screen. It's running just under like $39. You can also find coupon codes that go with it. If you, during the summer, AliExpress, I'm finding is really fast on shipping. They've been getting everything to me in about 5 to 10 days. So thanks for watching, and until next time, have a great day.